Hey there everyone, Ramesh here. In this video, I'm going to talk about what are the typical skills required to become a full stack Java developer. Well, I often receive emails and DMs from you guys like what are the skills that you need to, you know, learn to become a full stack Java developer. Well, in this video, I'm going to talk about what are the tools and technologies that you need to learn to become a full stack Java developer. So IT companies prefer hiring full stack Java developer instead of hiring two individual developers to work on front-end development and back-end development. So IT companies prefer hiring a single candidate who have a skills on front-end development as well as back-end development. Alright, and full stack Java developer is basically a high paying job right now. As a full stack Java developer, you should have hands-on experience on front-end development as well as back-end development. Alright, so in this video, I'm going to tell you what are the skills that you need to learn to become a full stack Java developer, and also you able to, you know, develop web application from start to end. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. So first we'll look into the backend development technologies and tools, and then we'll look into the frontend development tools and technologies, and then we'll also look into the database, and finally we'll put all the frontend backend skills together to develop application architecture for Angular, Springboard, Code full stack application. Alright, so once we'll familiar with all the skills, we will put together all the skills to design an architecture for Angular, Springboard, Code, full stack application. Let's begin with what are the skills that you need to learn to work upon backend Java development. Well, of course, you should have hands-on experience on core Java. So if you develop any Java application, you should have to write some core logic or business logic, right? For that, you need to learn core Java first. And if you want to develop REST APIs in Java community, we have different options. So either you can use Spring Boot, Jersey framework, or REST-EG. So I prefer using Spring Boot because there are a lot of features Spring Boot provides to develop REST APIs production ready. So I prefer using Spring Boot, and I highly suggest you guys to use Spring Boot to develop REST APIs as well as microservices. So in Java community, we have these three options to develop RESTful web services, and I suggest you to use Spring Boot. And apart from the REST APIs, you can also develop Spring MUC web application using Spring MUC module. Well, at the DAO layer, we have different options like Hibernate, Eclipse Link, Spring Data JPA. So Hibernate and Eclipse Link, so these are the two JPA implementations, I would say popular JPA implementations, and Hibernate is more popular than Eclipse Link. So I highly suggest you guys to learn Hibernate to develop the DAO layer. And Spring Data JPA is basically an abstraction layer on top of JPA, and Spring Data JPA internally uses Hibernate as a JPA provider, and we can use Spring Data JPA to reduce a lot of boilerplate code that is required to develop a DAO layer. Well, if you are developing Spring Boot applications, then prefer using Spring Data JPA, and it internally uses Hibernate as default JPA provider. Alright, so once you develop a REST APIs, you need to secure your REST endpoints, right? For that, you need a security module. So here I suggest you to use Spring Security. So Spring Security provides authentication as well as authorization features. You can use Spring Security to secure REST APIs as well as web applications. And we need an IDE, right? So IDE is a very important tool for Java developers to build a Java application. So here are the two popular IDEs. Either you can use Eclipse or IntelliJ IDEA to develop Java applications at a backend. And finally, you should have knowledge on Maven or Gradle. So these are the two popular build tools. You can use either one to work on Java project. So So these are the difficult skills that you require to work on backend Java development. Now let's take a look into the front-end development skills, HTML, JavaScript and CSS. So make sure that you have a good understanding of HTML, JavaScript and CSS in order to work on front-end development. So we use HTML to develop web pages and JavaScript to manipulate DOM elements and CSS to style the web pages. So once you're familiar with these three web development fundamentals, then you can learn a modern front-end framework. Either you can learn Angular, React or Vue.js. So make sure that once you are familiar with HTML, JavaScript and CSS, you should learn at least one front-end framework. You can learn either Angular, React.js or Vue.js. So I have published a full stack series on Angular, Spring Boot, crude full stack development series on my YouTube channel. You can check it out. And I also published a same series using React.js and Spring Boot. So you guys can check out these two series on my YouTube channel in order to develop a full stack web application using Spring Boot, React and Angular. And I will plan to create a same series with Vue.js and Spring Boot as well in future. So once you will learn one of the front-end framework, then you need to also learn the Node.js or npm. So you need npm tool in order to install packages and JavaScript libraries. And then we need a IDE to develop a front-end applications, right? So here we have different options like Visual Studio Code IDE, we have Storm and Sublime Text. So these are the commonly used IDEs or editors to work on front-end development. So I prefer using Visual Studio Code IDE and Sublime Text because these are free and open source IDEs, and I highly suggest you guys to check out these editors or IDEs to work on front-end development. Alright, so these are the common skills to work on front-end development. Now we had a look into the back-end development skills and front-end development skills. Now let's take into the database level. So once we develop a web application, we need to have a database in order to store the data, right? So either you can use a relational databases or NoSQL database. So here, look at here, MySQL, PostgreSQL, MS SQL Server, Oracle. So these are the commonly used relational databases, and MongoDB is a NoSQL database. So we have lot of NoSQL databases like MongoDB, Elasticsearch, Cassandra, CouchDB. So you can use either relational databases or NoSQL databases as per your project requirement. So whenever you work as a full stack Java developer, then you should have also knowledge on database. Well, once we are familiar with front-end development skills, back-end development skills and database, then let's put it together, all these skills, to create an architecture to develop an Angular, Spring Boot, crude full stack application. So look at here, this is the architecture that I have created to develop Angular, Spring Boot, crude full stack application. So look at here, the server side, at the backend side we have Spring Boot application, and at the front end side we have Angular application. So you can use either Angular or React or Vue.js at the front end, but in this video I just take this Angular as an as a front end framework to demonstrate the full stack application architecture here. So let's first take a look into the backend Spring Boot application architecture. So here we have a Spring REST controller and Spring Data JPA component in Spring Boot project. So Spring REST controller, basically we use to develop REST endpoints, and Spring REST controller, it invokes Spring Data JPA repositories to access the data. Spring Data JPA basically we use to reduce a lot of boilerplate code that's required to develop a DAO layer. And Spring Data JPA internally uses Hibernate as a default JPA provider. And Spring Data JPA basically it interacts with a MySQL database. You can use any relational databases or NoSQL databases at the database level. So in this just example, I have used MySQL here. So Spring Data JPA communicates with the MySQL database to store the data, to access the data, update the data, delete the data. Alright. And here basically we develop this Spring Boot application to expose the REST endpoints. So let's take a look at Angular application architecture. So look at here, we have different components in Angular application. We have view templates, components, services, and we may have a directives, pipes, etc. So we use HTML to develop templates, and components basically contains a properties and methods, so which will handle the data for templates, and we can perform two-way binding between template and component. So basically we use Angular interpolation to bind a properties in templates. Components will basically handle a user interface data. Services are Angular services where we keep all the common logic, and we inject services in required components using Angular dependency injection. And in our application, we write all the REST client code in services to make a REST API call. Well, Angular has its own HTTP module, so we can use HTTP module to make a REST API call. Okay, great. Alright guys, this is the architecture of full stack Angular Spring Boot application. So apart from front-end development skills and back-end development skill, it's also important to look into the tools that are required for deployment and maintaining the version control of your project. Right, so here are the tools that I'm going to suggest you learn. Git and SVN for as a version control system. So Git is a very popular and essential tool for a Java developer or full stack Java developer to maintain a version of your projects. And Jenkins is again a very essential tool for full stack Java developer for continuous integration and continuous delivery of your project. Docker is again a very essential tool for full stack Java developer. Basically we use Docker to deploy microservices on different containers. So you can use Docker to deploy applications on cloud or any remote server. And Jira is very again a must known tool for a Java or full stack Java developer who are working on the IT companies which uses agile methodologies. Let me recap what we have learned in this video. We first looked into the backend development skills like core Java, Spring Boot, Jersey REST and REST Easy. So these are the three frameworks which we can use to develop a REST APIs, and I suggest you to use Spring Boot to develop a REST APIs as well as web applications. At a DAO layer, you can use Spring Data JPA, internally use Hibernate as a JPA provider, or you can also use Eclipse Link based on your project requirement. And to secure the REST APIs and the web applications, you can use a Spring Security. Spring Security basically provides authentication and authorization features. You can use Eclipse or IntelliJ IDEA to develop a Java projects, and you can use either Maven or Gradle as a build tool. So these are the skills for backend development, and we looked into the front-end development skills like HTML, JavaScript and CSS. So these are the three web development fundamentals. And then we looked into the front-end modern frameworks like Angular, React and Vue.js. And we need a NPM to install JavaScript packages and libraries. And then we need IDE to develop front-end application, right? And here are the options like Visual Studio Code IDE, WebStorm, Sublime Text. So I suggest you to use VS Code IDE because it is open source and free IDE for front-end development. And then we looked into the databases, the relational databases and NoSQL databases. So the commonly used relational databases like MySQL, Postgres, MS SQL Server, Oracle, MariaDB. So there are a lot of relational databases out there. You can use any of the relational databases, but make sure that as a full stack Java developer, you should also have a understanding of databases. And then we put all the skills together, and we looked into how to design the architecture for full stack application using Angular and Spring Boot. Alright guys, I hope you understood the skills, the tools and technologies that you need to learn to become a full stack Java developer. Well, if I'm missing any skills in this video, then let me know in a comment section so that everybody can refer it. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I will see you guys in next video.